But then at the end of the day, also, you have the Duterte's consolidating. That's what I wanted to ask you. You now have Vice President Sara for sure will be supported by her father, and you have other officials. I mean, Pantaleon Alvarez, I mean, people that weren't speaking before are now consolidated against the Marcoses. Don't you consider that, frankly, I mean, formidable? I mean, when it comes to Mindanao, for example, it's still the Dutertes that are leading. And in the Visayas, there's still a part of the Dutertes. I believe a part of the Visayas that are still where the Dutertes are quite high.
Yes, but halimbawa sa Visayas, Governor Gwen Garcia has left PDP Laban. And yung successor ni Mayor Rama, si Vice Mayor Garcia, mukhang ay inabandon na rin yung PDP Laban. So makikita mo ha, buong Cebu na beforehand was all PDP Laban ay ngayon ay nasa administration na. So that's an example na mahihirapan
And
yung
when we talk
Duterte
about
cabinet.
Cebu, we mean Cebu province.
NCT. Dahil yung isang Garcia is now the acting mayor of the city. No? At mukhang iniwan na niya si Mike Rama. Tapos sa Mindanao naman, karamihan ng mga local officials dyan will be with the administration. Hindi naman kandidato si Sara, hindi naman kandidato si Digong. So, ang boboto dyan are local officials. No? Pwedeng ma-deliver nila ang Mindanao for their national candidates. Pero sa local, I'm almost sure they will be wiped out. Halimbawa, Southern Mindanao is Pacquiao country. Sarangani, General Santos, South Cotabato, no? So, ano yung matitira sa mga Duterte? It's basically Davao, pero meron na rin silang kalaban sa Davao, di ba? So, iba yung local, Congress, local officials, iba yung national. Perhaps, sabi ko nga kanina, sa Senate ay madideliver nila yung parts, large parts of Mindanao. But sa local candidates, sa congressional candidates, I'm almost totally sure they will be wiped out.
So let's fast forward to 4 years. Is this administration, is President Marcos Jr. building a successor? Because some have said that's the problem with the late president Noynoy Aquino. He wasn't able to unite Mar Rojas and Grace Poe, which actually led to the disintegration of his power block. And to a degree, it's right? So what should this administration do to ensure that their candidate is the winning candidate for 2028? At some point, you need to build.
Well, una, ay tingin ko hindi pa tapos yung political project ng mga iba dyan to push for charter change. Tingin ko magkakaroon pa ng last push for charter change. At alam naman natin, pag nag-succeed yan, ay hindi lang economic provisions ang gagalawin yan. No? So yun yung una.
Do you believe Senate President Cheese Escudero will support that when he
I
was
doubt it.
that's the
I doubt
point.
it. Yeah. Ang point
Because
ko
he
lang
was
ay there will be
opposing,
a push.
there'll be a push.
Whether it will succeed is a different thing. Tingin ko uphill pa rin, no? But there will still be a push.
Because one of the criticisms with the Senate coup is the fact that the power block in the Senate that was removed actually somehow supported is it RBH6? I can't remember right now, but essentially some of the economic changes for the charter. And this new power block, well, at least the leadership has claimed they do not.
Yes. That's why it will be uphill. But ang sinasabi ko lang, Karen, they will still push for it. No? One last try. No? Ikalawa ay kung walang viable candidate ang mga Marcoses, ang isang option nila ay to support somebody na hindi talaga organically kasama nila. No? To get a black swan candidate na
Like
itutulak
Raffy
nila.
Tulfo, you mean?
Yes, na against the Duterte. Just to defeat the Duterte. Kaya that's still an option to be a kingmaker, no? To push for at sa ngayon yung pwede nilang himukin to be their candidate na hindi naman nila kalaban is the Tulfos. At least one of them. Sa ngayon, ang lumalabas, si Senator Raffy Tulfo. At sa survey, ay either kapantay o nalampasan na niya si Sara Duterte. At hindi pa siya nag-a-announce. Ibig sabihin, hindi pa siya nagpapakilala as a presidential candidate or timber. After the midterms, it's a different thing. Kaya he is somebody to watch. Pero yung gobyerno, kung wala silang talagang kandidato, ay hindi malayo that they negotiate and support somebody na winnable against the Duterte, dahil kung hindi sila manalo sa mga Duterte, baka delikado sila, baka gantihan sila. At yung foreign policy nila na pivot away from China ay baka mabago. So very fundamental itong labanan sa 2028, dahil hindi lang ito labanan for the presidency of the Philippines. It's a labanan between the two superpowers.
Okay, here's another question for you. One of the reasons they say why President Marcos Jr. got, I believe it was 31 million votes, right? In the last elections, a whopping 31 million votes, is essentially he was able to unite. That's why it's the unity with Sara Duterte, who in the surveys before leading up to the elections, they were higher. Close. 25, 26, something, etc. Yeah. Then you had Eleni Robredo. Right? So then you had, because they united, you had Leni Robredo that got half of Marcos's votes. Yes. But then in the coming elections, it might be a 3 or 4 way playing field. So you may now have the Marcos candidate, Sara Duterte, running if she does run. And then some have said, will former Vice President Leni Robredo now have a chance? Because if you split it in three, that changes everything.
That's a distinct possibility, no? Mm-hmm. Posible na three-way fight. I doubt lang kung si Leni Robredo yan, dahil nag-decision na siya na she will go local.
Yeah.
No?
Yeah.
She will run for mayor of Naga City. So hindi ko sigurado kung siya ay, pero yung grupo ni Leni will definitely field somebody, no? Mm-hmm. Unless hindi maging viable, then you can see possible coalitions na mangyari sa 2028, no? Hindi yan sarado. Dahil bottom line, will they permit a Duterte presidency kung malakas pa si Sara? Dahil hindi na rin invincible si Sara, nakakaramdam na rin siya ng kanyang political mortality. At makikita natin yan in the next survey before and after the midterms, no? Kaya yung pagiging high ni Sara sa preferential option for the presidency may no longer hold water in the next few months or years.
Because what you're saying is it's the performance in the local that will matter.
Yes, and it's about the movement of numbers. Eh. It's not absolute numbers. If you look at the absolute numbers, perhaps nasa top 1, top 2 pa rin si Sara. But if you look at the movement of numbers, it is moving downwards. Kung hindi nila mapipigilan yung movement downwards, then they have a big problem going into 2028. There might be other alternatives to them going into 2028. Kaya nga siguro, isang dahilan kung bakit siya nag-resign, baka susubukin nilang pigilan itong downward trend na ito. Pero from my vantage point, it's a bit too late. They should have done that much earlier to salvage what they have. Ngayon, baka mahirapan.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, former Secretary for Political Affairs, political analyst Ronald Liamas. Thank you once again, sir. And good luck with your speech in the U.S.
Maraming salamat, Karen.